we want to solve the given rational inequality. In general, to solve a rational inequality, we want to start by factoring the numerator and denominator, then determine the zeros of the numerator and denominator, and then we'll plot these zeros on the number line, which will form intervals, and then we'll test each interval to see which intervals satisfy the original inequality. So looking at our rational inequality, the first step is going to be to factor the numerator. It'll factor into two binomial factors. Factors of x squared are x and x. The factors of negative 12 that add to negative 4 would be negative 6 and positive 2. And now we'll find the zeros of the numerator and denominator. So looking at the numerator, we want to know when the quantity x minus 6 times the quantity x plus 2 equals 0. Well, this equals 0 when these factors are equal to 0. So we'd have x equals 6 or x equals negative 2. And then for the denominator, we want to know when x minus 2 equals 0. Well, that occurs when x equals 2. So now we'll plot these values on the number line and then test each interval. But when plotting these zeros of the numerator, they can either be open points or closed points based upon the original inequality. Notice that 6 and negative 2 make the numerator equal to 0, and therefore this fraction would equal 0. And since we want to know when this fraction is less than or equal to 0, these two values would satisfy the inequality, and therefore we make closed points on positive 6 and negative 2 to show these two values are included as part of the solutions. So we have negative 2 here, let's say positive 6 here with closed points. So when plotting the zeros of the numerator, the points can be open or closed based upon the original inequality. The zeros of the denominator will always be open points because we must exclude the values to make the denominator equal to 0 because we'd have division by 0. So we'll have an open point at x equals 2. And now we'll test each interval to see which satisfy the original inequality. So in this interval, let's test x equals negative 3. Here we'll test x equals 0. Here we'll test x equals 3. And here we'll test x equals 7. So if these values satisfy the original inequality, then the entire interval would be part of the solution. And we'll do this using the factored form of the inequality. So when x is negative 3, notice how we'd have negative 9 times negative 1, that would be positive 9, divided by negative 3 minus 2 is negative 5. Well, this is obviously negative. A negative number is always going to be less than or equal to 0, so this is true, which means this entire interval is part of the solution. Again, this was true. Now let's test x equals 0. Well, if x is 0, we would have negative 6 times positive 2, that's negative 12, divided by negative 2, that's positive 6. Positive 6 is not less than or equal to 0, so this is false. So we'll skip this interval and go to the next interval. When x is 3, notice how we'd have negative 3 times 5, which is negative 15, divided by 3 minus 2 is 1. Well, negative 15 is less than or equal to 0, so this is true, which means this entire interval is part of the solution. And now we'll test x equals 7. When x is 7, we'd have 1 times 9, that's 9, divided by 5. Well, this is obviously positive. A positive number is never less than or equal to 0, so this is false. So these two intervals would be our solution. Let's go ahead and express this using interval notation and inequalities. So this interval would be from negative infinity to negative 2, closed on negative 2. Union, the interval from 2 to 6, open on 2 and closed on 6. Or using inequalities, we could say x is less than or equal to negative 2, or x is greater than 2 and less than or equal to 6. Now there is a nice way to check this graphically. So let's do that now. If we want to solve this inequality graphically, we can graph the function y equals the quantity x squared minus 4x minus 6 divided by x minus 2. And since we want to know when this is less than or equal to 0, we want to know when this graph is on or below the x-axis, because that is when y would be less than or equal to 0. So looking at our graph, notice how we do have a slant asymptote. We'd also have a vertical asymptote at x equals 2. So let's go ahead and sketch that here. So again, if we want to solve this graphically, we want to know when the function is on or below the x-axis, because that's when the y values would be less than or equal to 0. So if we take a look at the left part of the graph, notice how when x is less than or equal to negative 2, or from this point to the left, the blue graph is on or below the x-axis, and therefore it would satisfy the inequality. And then on the right, notice how this piece here is on or below the x-axis. And since the graph is going to be approaching this vertical asymptote on the interval from 2 to positive 6, this interval here, the y values would be less than or equal to 0. So the interval from 2 to 6, open on 2, closed on 6, would also be a solution to the inequality. Notice how these intervals match our solutions on the previous screen here. So I think checking our work graphically is a nice way of verifying our work. Okay, we'll take a look at another example in the next video.